Hi, you guys. I hope you are all well. It's Asia Marke here, Lemon Creation, with two projects today. One is the bonus one made very quickly, and you can see it at the end of this video. And here are my two tags, so let's dive in. It's been a long time since I've done tags, and I am not even sure they are actually tags because I didn't pierce the hole in them, I didn't put the, you know, the ribbon, but they are not ATCs because they are much bigger, and very likely they're gonna finish in my one of my art journal page. But the size is more or less standard size for the tags, and as you've seen on the mixed media paper, I added a little bit spritz, a little bit of water, and then I'm adding two colors. One is Squirt, the red one. It's All Canada Crimson. And for the list of products, please check the description box below so you'll find them. And the second one is unfortunately a product which is discontinued by Lindy's, but this is one of my favorite colors ever, Wood Violet Blue. But as I said, I'm sorry, you cannot really buy it anymore. But I still use it. I'm almost at the end of the box, and I'm gonna finish using it. I'm adding a little bit of ink, black one, to the cards, so they are having this Halloween feel, and they are well finished, and there is no this white edge sticking out. Firstly, I added archival ink, just for the edges, and now I'm adding Distress Oxide, because simply my archival ink is quite dry already, and it wouldn't actually give me so much color with the sponge. And now for the stamp, I'm using Studio Light stamp, and I am stamping it with archival ink. And this is my tissue paper I'm using. When I'm spraying the paper, I'm putting it underneath so the sprays don't go all over my desk or the box I'm using. And I decided, before throwing it out to the bin, I decided, why not? People are using scrap papers, why not use this one? And I choose the parts which are the darkest, obviously, because it's a Halloween project, so it has to be dark. And as you see, on purpose, I actually let them stick out a little bit from the tags, and I glue them with a normal, just, you know, children kind of glue stick. But of course, you can use, I don't know, gel, matte gel, for example. But be careful, because I used Lindy's. Lindy's are not waterproof. So if I was to use, you know, the matte gel, I would probably just, you know, move the colors around. So that's why also I used the glue. And I added a little bit of splatter. And this is my focal point, one of my focal points. I absolutely love them. I actually bought them on Etsy. They are digital papers. And I'm gonna give you a name of the person who's selling them. I think she drew them by herself, and if that's the case, yes, as far as I know, she drew them by herself. She's a great artist. They are really adorable, so, so beautiful. And so you can cut the parts of these weird kind of dolls, I'd say. And you can arrange them the way you want. They come with small elements like, you know, the skull and the heart. And as you've seen, I am adding them, gluing part by part. So I kind of tilted her head. I added a small heart. And at the end, you've seen me, I actually added a little bit of dark to one side of the body. So like that, it looks better. This one I wanted to change a little bit. I wanted kind of his head to float, or her head. Yes, it's her head, because she's still a girl, you're gonna see by looking at her shoes later on. But oh, I do nothing right now. I think I forgot to kind of end this part of the video, but anyway, I'm gonna talk. So what I've done, I cut a part of the paper to add as a neck like a, you know. It took me a while, so as you can see, my head was already well glued to the paper. So out of the camera, I kind of, you know, I kind of removed it. Still, I managed, and I put the neck underneath, so like that is better. And I decided to put the hands not upside down, but not the good way around. Oh my goodness, I don't know. And as you can see, well, I don't know, I hope you can see, her shoes have tiny ribbons to it, so that's why I'm thinking it's a hair, even though, oh my goodness, she's not that cute. I mean, she's very cute, but you know, for a girl, she could look a little bit better. And so I added also a buttons, but for the heart on the other tag and for the buttons here, I actually used a 3D foam, so they are sticking out. And I wanted to make small accents which kind of go with the background, so I added a little bit of dots with the purple mark. And here, as you can see, I put a crown on her head. The crown is not actually a crown, it's a hand which I cut it and I made it look like a crown, because why not, it's funnier this way. I put 3D tape and place it on the black, not 3D tape, I put a double-sided tape and place it on the black background, and I added my words to it. And here are the finished pictures, the close-ups. I hope you like this project. Just stay tuned, in a few seconds you're gonna see my second project, which I used for which I used the tissue paper, you know, my old sprayed tissue paper. But I have to tell you, I absolutely love this project. It's just so funny. I wish I could draw like that, because this is just like, I absolutely love these weird people, weird dolls, weird things like that, because I find them funny. And it's not really a scary Halloween project, but it's a funny one. Welcome back. I am almost finishing my this art journal, and I found one page just beside the one, obviously, which is Halloween page, and I decided to, you know, to continue and make on the other side also something Halloween-y. So firstly, which you cannot see because it was a long time ago, I covered the page with black gesso. That's a black gesso, and today, or yesterday, I did it yesterday, I wanted to add a little bit of stamping, so I stays on a purple ink and caramel stamp, and I was thinking that maybe it will work, and it actually didn't. Well, you can still see it here, the stamp, but it was actually a small mistake to do it like that. I learned something that way. Because the moment I add this much, I'm adding, and the pieces of the tissue from before, the moment I add much gel, all the stamping disappeared, despite the fact that it was stays on ink. But yes, that's one more experience. I could have cut it out and not show you guys, but I wanted. And anyway, if you would do that just on the black page without adding, you know, the tissue paper, you would still have this impression I had before. There were schools actually visible, not very much, but they were. Could have been nice for any other project, but not for this one, because I really wanted to cover the page with a tissue I had left. I didn't want it to do a very minimalistic page, because I wanted them both to match, like the one on the left with the one on the right, and as you can see, the one on the left is quite charged with elements. And I'm using the opaque Saison ink, so I can add some white motif, because as you can see on the left hand side, my page has still a tiny bit of negative space. And yes, it's true, for Halloween we don't usually use white, but why not change things a little? And because I didn't have big enough acrylic block, it's true. I'm stamping a lot and I still don't have enough acrylic blocks. I used my palette, but to keep it in place, I added adhesive dots. So like that, my stamp didn't fall off. And now I'm removing the adhesive blocks. So for some of you who don't have big acrylic blocks, here is the hint what you can do. And I love the impression of the stamp. It worked really well. I was not sure it's gonna stamp so well. I decided also to add a little bit of splatter, of course. So for that, I'm using my all-time favorite snowflake chalk acrylic from Paper Artsy. Chalk acrylics from Paper Artsy are just so, so beautiful. I really love them, and this one is my favorite, and I actually have to buy another one because it's almost finished. And with this brush, you know, I don't know, it's like a kind of fun brush, I got the splatter, like I got a kind of big ones, big dots. And now I'm using my own elements from the collection Black and White. And I was not sure, I have also from Winged and Seo and company, the red one, but the red one didn't work well because it was, well, too red for the page. So the best is to add some contrast, and now I got this back, and I think it matches the page the best. And I wanted to add a little bit of borders to the page because you can see there is still a margin visible, but that doesn't bother me so much because it is actually Halloween page, and the margin also added a kind of bit of texture to the page. So I just wanted to I just wanted to kind of frame it so like that, you know, you can see that it's not really a mistake, that it could be a part of the page and it doesn't bother me at all. So I am framing around the margin also. They are both such a simple project, wouldn't you agree? And it's been really fun. It's so nice also to use some of your scrap papers, in this case some of the scrap tissue. And to finish this page off, I added my really messy words. It's the new book I put in my shop, I think 2 weeks ago. There is more words in this one, and some of them, they would match the Halloween mood. So that's it, guys. Please subscribe to my channel, as always, leave a comment or a question if you have. And please also check my shop, I have some products there, I hope for Christmas also, which is coming. I hope you're gonna find your happiness. And that would mean a lot to me, since I am a really, really tiny business. For now, I wish you a beautiful day. And well, see you soon, I hope. Bye bye.